Countdown is sponsored by I Believe Gel. Pain relief you can count on.
Well, today is the day we've been building up to for the last 6 months. It's the series final, and boy, am I nervous. Unlike our contestants, who are nice and calm and collected, I am a bag of nerves. My hands are sweating, my knees are knocking. You see, this is my first countdown final as host. At every game since January, I've happily sat behind this desk. Today, my worst nightmare is about to come true. You see, at the end of the programme, I've got to stand up for the winner's presentation. It means that in less than 45 minutes, you lot out there are going to find out just how tall or short the Stelling really is. My secret will be over. And it doesn't help that if you pile up the main prize of the complete set of leather-bound, gold-leaf Oxford English dictionaries, it's taller than me. Here's somebody else who's taller than me. Rachel Riley. Hi, Rachel.
Hello, Jim.
Rachel, any chance of taking those heels off and helping me out?
Why, did you want to borrow them? I'm a size 7, that's about right, isn't it?
They're not my colour, darling, actually.
Oh.
I have to say, it's a very nice outfit today.
Thank you very much. I normally get told off, whenever I wear red in the studio, I get told off for wearing Man United colours. So I'm in Leeds colours today. I've got white and a little bit of yellow.
Very nice indeed. Let's meet our two finalists, shall we? First of all, Jimmy Goff. Following his defeat of James Doohan in the quarterfinal match, the third seed Jimmy claimed his place in today's final by beating Hamish Williamson by 88 points to 58 yesterday. That took Jimmy's total points score to 953. It gave him an average of 95 points over the 10 games he's played so far. Not bad for a young man who only wanted a teapot, eh, Jimmy?
Yeah.
You feeling confident?
Not at all. I'm quite scared, actually, of the calculator.
You just relax. The man he's scared of is Kirk Bevins. After a nail-biting quarter-final in which he beat Julie Russell by 115 points to 90, Kirk went head-to-head with student Neil Zussman in the semi. It was a game which went right down to the wire. Kirk claimed the match and his place in today's final by correctly guessing that the conundrum was eclampsia. Kirk scored 98 to Neil's 88. It brings his points total to a massive 1,138 over 10 games, an average of more than 113. Well, you've made it to the final, Kirk. Well done on that. You've had a couple of very worthy competitors along the way, though, haven't you?
Definitely. That semi-final on Wednesday was a bit of a nightmare.
Feeling good?
Not really.
So that's neither of you feeling good. One of you will be by the end of the programme, that's for sure. Our finalists are Jimmy Goff and Kirk Bevins. Let's meet our guest in Dictionary Corner. He was the presenter of Trust Me, I'm a Doctor, the author of Medicine Balls. He's a comedian and a GP. Dr. Phil Hammond. Hi, Phil.
Hi there.
Thank you. And during the course of the week, Phil has been teaching us all how to be GPs in 5 easy lessons. Have you got the diplomas ready for the end
of
the day?
I have. This is the hardest one, though. We're doing dealing with emergencies. The excitement gets too much. So this is the very important final lesson.
Okay.
Not to be missed.
We look forward to it. Well, most of us look forward to it, though I suspect sitting alongside Phil in Dictionary Corner, she's not looking forward to it. One jot, Susie Dent. Are you worried about what he might come up with?
Yes, I've got the patience charter with me today.
OK, on to the Series 60 final. Here's the first round. It's a letters round, and, Jimmy, it's your pick.
Good afternoon, Rachel.
Good afternoon, Jimmy.
I'll start with a consonant, please.
Thank you. Good luck to you both. Start with T.
And a vowel.
E.
A consonant.
P.
A vowel.
A.
Consonant.
N.
A vowel.
E.
Consonant.
D.
A vowel.
Another E.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final S.
And for the first time in this final, it's time to start the countdown clock. Kirk, how many?
Seven.
And Jimmy?
Seven as well.
Jimmy, what have you got?
Deepens.
Yeah, deepens. And Kirk?
Nepetters.
Nepetters.
How are you spelling that, Kirk?
It's a Kirk word, isn't it?
Nepetters.
Is that a plant?
Is it?
I think.
Oh, Nepetters, then.
Yes, plants that include catmint and several kinds cultivated for their spikes of blue or violet flowers. Brilliant.
Very good.
Well done.
Yeah, a couple of very good sevens. I think we set the standard for the final already, don't you? Jimmy, seven. Kirk, seven. What about Dictionary Corner? What have you got, folks?
We've got pedants, or pedants, if you're being pedantic about it. Thank you. I'm here all week.
Well done. On to our next round. Another letters round, of course, and Kirk, you'll go.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Kirk.
Can I have a consonant, please?
You can start with P.
And another?
L.
The third, please.
Another L.
And a fourth, please.
B.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
I.
Vowel.
O.
Vowel.
E.
And a consonant, please.
And the last one, R.
Your 30 seconds starts now. Jimmy, what have you got?
Seven.
And Kirk?
And seven.
OK, what's yours, Kirk?
Pallia.
Pallia. And Jimmy?
Parboil.
Mm. Yep, parboil. Both in and both excellent.
Yeah, very good indeed. Very good. Jimmy has 14 and Kirk has 14. This time, Jimmy, it's your pick of the letters.
OK, can I start with a consonant, please?
Thank you, Jimmy. N.
And a vowel.
O.
A consonant.
L.
A vowel.
U.
Consonant.
J.
A vowel.
A.
Consonant.
N.
A vowel.
O.
And a final consonant, please.
And lastly, T.
And time starts now. Kirk?
I'll try a six.
OK. Jimmy?
Just five.
OK, what's the five, Jimmy?
Talon.
Talon. And the six, Kirk?
Nounal.
Nounal.
Nounal. To do with nouns. Yes, it is there, specified under noun.
Wow. Oh,
grammatical term, obviously. Very good.
Yeah, very good indeed.
Yeah.
Didn't think there were many sixes around in that little collection.
No, embarrassed I didn't get that one.
Jimmy has 14, Kirk has 20. Kirk's pick of the letters.